आई एम रीमा के बी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिक्स, महारानी साइंस कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन, मैसूर. लेट्स डिस्कस रिगार्डिंग न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन सरफेस टेंशन एंड अ पेपर टाइटल्ड मैकेनिक्स, प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ मैटर एंड इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक्स, सेशन नंबर 40. सरफेस टेंशन, न्यूमेरिकल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन सरफेस टेंशन. लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव. Students learn to solve problems on surface tension. Session outcomes. Learn to write data and solve problems on surface tension. Problem number 1. Calculate the excess of pressure in a soap bubble of radius 3 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Surface tension of soap solution is 0.02 Newton per meter. Also, calculate the surface energy. Solution. Excess of pressure inside soap bubble is given by P is equal to 4T by R. Substituting for surface tension T and radius R in the expression for P, we get P is equal to 26.66 Newton per meter square. Therefore, surface energy can be given by E is equal to T into surface area, which is equal to T times 4 pi R square. Substituting for T, pi and R, we get the value of E for surface energy as E is equal to 2.26 into 10 to the power minus 6 joules. Problem number 2. There is minute circular hole at the bottom of a small hollow vessel. The vessel has to be immersed in water to a depth of 0.4 meter before any water penetrates inside. Find the radius of the hole if the surface tension and density of water are 0.073 Newton per meter and 1000 kg per meter cube respectively. Solution. Water penetrates only when the hydrostatic pressure exceeds the excess of pressure due to surface tension. At the limiting condition, when the water just penetrates, these pressures are equal. Hence, rho gh is equal to 2t by r. Substituting for rho gh, t and r in the above expression, we get the value of radius r is equal to 3.72 times 10 to the power minus 5 meter. Problem number 3. The interiors of a cylindrical and a spherical soap bubble put into communication. Determine the ratio of the radii of sphere and the cylinder in order that the bubbles may be in equilibrium. Solution. The bubbles in communication will be in equilibrium only when the excess of pressure inside these bubbles are equal, that is Pc is equal to Ps, which implies 2T by Rc is equal to 4T by Rs. Therefore, Rs by Rc is equal to 2. Problem number 4. Calculate the work done and excess of pressure inside the case of a soap bubble of diameter 2 cm. Surface tension of soap solution is 2.9 times 10 to the power into 10 Newton per meter square. Solution. Radius of the bubble is equal to half of its diameter, equal to 1 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter. For a bubble, the total surface area S of the equation is given by S is equal to 2 into 4 pi R square, which is equal to 2 into 4 pi times 10 to the power minus 2 whole square. So, we get the value of surface area S as 2.51 times 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. Amount of work W done is equal to T times S. Substituting for T and S in the expression for W, we get W is equal to 7.28 into 10 to the power minus 5 joules. Excess of pressure P inside. P is equal to 4T by R. which is equal to 4 into 2.9 times 10 to the power minus 2 by 10 to the power minus 2. Therefore, value of P is equal to 11.6 Newton per meter square. Problem number 5. What is the amount of work to be done against surface tension when a water drop of diameter 0.2 cm splits into 27,000 drops of equal volume? Surface tension of water is equal to 0.07 Newton per meter. Solution. 27,000 times 4 by 3 into pi r cube is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Therefore, r is equal to r by 30, which is equal to 1 by 3 times 10 to the power minus 4 meter. Increase in area is equal to 27,000 times 4 pi r square minus 4 pi r square. Substituting the value of r and r in the expression for increase in area, we get the value of the increase in area as 3.64 times 10 to the power minus 4 meter square. We know that work done is equal to surface tension into increase in area. Substituting the value of surface tension and the increase in area, we get the value of work done as 2.55 times 10 to the power minus 5 joules. Problem number 6. What would be the pressure inside a small air bubble of 0.1 millimeter radius situated just below the surface of water? Surface tension of water is equal to 0.072 Newton per meter and atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.013 times 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter square. Solution. Excess of pressure inside bubble, that is above atmospheric pressure, is P is equal to 2T by R. Substituting the value of T and R in the expression for P, we get P is equal to 0.0144 times 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter square. Therefore, total pressure inside air bubble is equal to 0.0144 times 10 to the power 5 plus 1.013 into 10 to the power 5. We get the total pressure inside air bubble is equal to 1.0274 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter square. Problem number 7. Calculate the pressure inside a drop of mercury of radius 2.5 times 10 to the power minus 3 meter at room temperature. What is the excess of pressure inside the drop given surface tension of mercury is equal to 472 into 10 to the power minus 3 Newton per meter and atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.01 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter square. Solution. Excess of pressure is P is equal to 2T by R, which is equal to 2 into 472 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 2.5 times 10 to the power minus 3. So, we get pressure P is equal to 377.6 Newton per meter square. Therefore, total pressure PT inside the drop is equal to atmospheric pressure plus P. Hence, we have PT is equal to P naught plus P. Therefore, PT is equal to 101377.6 Newton per meter square. Excess pressure P is equal to 2T by R. So, we have obtained the value of excess pressure as P is equal to 377.6 Newton per meter square. So, we have substituted this value of excess pressure in the above expression to obtain the value of total pressure inside the drop. Hope you have understood all the problems that we have solved here. Thank you. References: College Physics Volume 1, Mechanics, Oscillations and Properties of Matter, J.C. Upadhyaya, Himalaya Publishing House. Number 2, College Physics Volume 1, Mechanics, Properties of Matter, Heat and Thermodynamics by N. Sundarajan, George Thomas and Syed Aziz. Reference number 3, Properties of Matter by D.S. Mathur. Thank you.